Alright, welcome back, ETC Sleeper Gang. We are back. But before we get into the video, if you guys wouldn't mind, do leave a like, comment, sub. All that fun stuff helps with the YouTube algorithm, helps out the channel grow. Really do appreciate it. Other than that, let's get on into this. So, we clearly are pumping towards the upside for today and as of yesterday. Yesterday, we closed with a total gain of 2.48%. So far today, we are currently up 2.71%. We do have a bit of a wick from the upside here. And as you guys can see on our CoinTrader Pro chart, next fib level towards upside that we would be looking for would actually be the 3618 once again, which is at $21.62. You can see last time that we got up to there, we were unable to close above there, but we did get a wick one day above there. So ideally, we do want to see a closure above there as well. And then continuing on from that, you do need to see a closure above this previous wick's high. But on top of that, you also want to see a higher high come from there, meaning you need to make a new high above. If you want the precise price is currently, or at least on this chart, is at $22.46. And if that does end up happening, I would think it's safe to say that you do actually end up breaking back towards the upside and do make a new high compared to the high that was made on February 4th, which was at $24.77. However, that's the next step, assuming that we do break above that prior high. So, yeah. Anyway, going back to our trading view chart, what are we going to be looking at right here? As of right now, to be completely honest, what we really need to see, we do need to see this high break for push towards upside. If you're unable to do that, then to be quite honest, what this looks like is clearly another lower high, because you had that high come in, then you made a lower high, and then you fell off the table, lower high. We've been going sideways a little bit, but if you make another lower high right here, then I would imagine that you're gonna fall off the table again a little bit. On top of that, even the high that we set back here, we were unable to take out at the very minimum the high set back right before the FTX drop in the beginning of November. So that is on the daily time frame. So let's switch over onto the 4 hour, see if we see anything differently. So what you did see right here was actually a descending channel, which what we know about channels are essentially whatever way the channel is going, you're ultimately going to get a impulsive move in the opposite direction once you break through the channel, or fully confirm that you break through that channel. So I wouldn't say you've fully confirmed that you've broken through it yet, seeing how we do have a wick on the 4 hour, just as so. And as of right now, you do technically have a bearish engulfing candle on the 4 hourly as of right now. So coming down for shorter time frame, look, what you're gonna ultimately be looking for is looking to hold this fib level right here, which would be the 618 at about $20.46. As long as you are able to hold above that with closures, you should be good. And then, the next line of support would be $20.14. After, if you were to end up breaking that, then I do think that you're going to be getting sent back down, and that this is another lower high, as we talked about. Otherwise, if you do end up getting closures above this previous high right here, as we did say, get sent back up. This on the 4 hour, can we see anything necessarily on the hourly? Hourly, not really so much. I wouldn't be fully convinced that this is your top on it just yet. I would imagine that this would be your support area sometime soon, and then if you do end up coming back up right here, what I'd be looking for is mainly to see whether or not this ends up being a lower high right here. If you do end up getting a lower high here on the hourly, 100%, I do think that you're going to be getting sent back down. Major area here on the hourly, let's switch over to the 15 minute, get a better idea. Area that you need to break on the hourly is going to be $20.95. Getting above there. So yeah, you did see increase pressure, selling pressure over here. Over here, not so much over here, but yeah. All right, so yeah, that's really going to be about it. Other than that, none of this financial advice. These are all just my thoughts and opinions, and you guys have a phenomenal day as always. Adios, muchachos.